Hello. Jumbo means hello in Kiswahili. Welcome. Good evening.
Good evening.
Okay, I'm closer. Hello, good evening. Hello to everyone here in the Lyceum and everyone joining us from Zoom. On behalf of the Change Group at Sandy Springs Monthly Meeting, I'd like to welcome you all to our second annual celebration of Juneteenth. And it's also the second year that Juneteenth is a national holiday. So this is really special. So, should I introduce the members of the Change Group at this point? Or, well, I think we're mingling around. So I'm Roxanne, and you will see the schedule for tonight coming on the screen in a moment. I just want to make everyone aware that there are snacks and there are drinks for those of us who are here in the Lyceum, and also, there is an art project that is going on in another corner of the room. Sophie is here to assist in creating a collaborative painting with the theme of Jubilee this year. All right. So as we mingle around later on, please feel free to add to the painting. We did one last year and it was really great to have your input and to put something together that everyone had a piece of. So please feel free to join in on that. Here is the schedule for tonight. It's up on the screen, and we'll be, of course, introducing each item on the agenda. So I think we'd like to start by just saying thank you once again for being here, for coming out, and for joining us on Zoom. And for right now, we'd like to introduce Cheryl McLeod, who will be pouring libation and doing a land acknowledgement for us. Cheryl, thank you so much for coming.
Welcome. Can you all hear me? Can you hear me? Can they hear me? Can you all hear? Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Woo. All right. Just want to make sure because this is definitely a day, a weekend, a holiday that we want to celebrate at the same time with a purpose. So we want to party, but we need to party with a purpose. Right. So whenever we start an event, an activity, a gathering, as this is today, our family gathering, there are two remembrances that we believe are so very important for us to never forget. And they have actually sort of been neglected in the past. As we are telling our stories, and our stories are our truth, the real story is exposed. And we as a country can move forward into making sure that our future is much brighter than our past. So we're going to start with a land acknowledgement. Then we're going to move into libation. The connection between the two will be water. With our land acknowledgement, let us begin by acknowledging that the land on which we gather is the traditional territory stolen from the Piscataway people. As we work towards truth and reconciliation to create spaces for healing and connection, let us first acknowledge the racial terror of colonialism. and attempted erasure of the indigenous people. So as we live, as we work, as we worship, as we walk, as we tour, let us also commit to learning and honoring the sacrifices, resistance, history, and culture of the first state recognized tribes in Maryland, the Piscataway Conoy Tribe and the Piscataway Indian Nation. So there are some symbols here of things that grow in the land, because our Native Americans relied much on nature. Water is important. In order for us to sustain ourselves, we must have water. Water is important to help things to grow. So the land is very treasured for our Native Americans because of the fact that they were on this land. And then the land was stolen from them. As we then acknowledge the ancestry of our African heritage, let us remember we were on our native land. We were taken from that land, brought across the ocean, water. And in that transition, when we landed in what is called now we know as America, we became enslaved. So we have land that was taken from people already here, and we have land and people who were taken from their land and brought here and were enslaved. It is very important that we recognize that our people were free and then were enslaved. So knowledge and words are important. And as we talk about our history, we want to try to remember we were not slaves,
right.
We were enslaved. Slave is a victim type of mentality and it describes a condition. We were enslaved, meaning our freedom was snatched from us. We are still a people, a proud people. And Juneteenth is so very important because for our people, we celebrate our freedom as Americans, as African Americans, as Africans, as Blacks on this land. So that is why it is important for us to remember that we are all people who were then forced to live under certain conditions. And the main condition for us is slavery. So one of the first things we want to do, traditionally speaking, we want to make sure that this is a safe and clean place for everyone. So this is symbolic of a broom. It's a little dust room, right? And so traditionally speaking, what we do is we sweep away all of the negative thoughts. We sweep away all of the evils that are upon us or trying to come at us. So we take a broom, and just as when we are married, we jump over the broom, which means that we want to start a new future, a bright future with a soulmate. We're sweeping away all of the negative things so that positive vibes can come into this room. So that is a tradition that we use that came from Africa that we bring here. So when you notice, particularly in the South, there are porches that are here too, but particularly in the South, when you see us sweeping the porch, right? We go sweep the sidewalk leading up to the house because we want there to be safe haven and welcoming from even the strangers that come by, anyone who comes up to us. So we do a whole lot of sweeping. And the sweeping is to make sure that positive spirits stay amongst us. So as we continue on today, let us think about, because I'm speaking away, all that negative stuff. At the same time, though, we have to combat and confront our enemies and the evils that come upon us. We must speak up, speak out, shout out. And as they say, if you see something, don't just say something, do something. I'd like to have some help for some libation. And what I need, here's what I need. I need someone who will hold the bowl. I need someone who will pour water into the bowl. And then I'm also gonna need, I have someone sitting here. No, this is the right place. For our drum. So I need three people. Well, it depends on who's coming up or the three people.
I'll hold the bowl.
Okay, hold the bowl. Okay, who's gonna pour the water? Tell you what, if you can do it like this, you think? See if that's too heavy. Is that good? We're good? All right, so we wanna make sure that everybody can see us. So. And we need someone to our drum. Yes, ma'am, absolutely. And the drummer you can have.
Oh,
drummer just to see. Okay, all right. Okay, now here's the thing. The drummer is a heartbeat. So the drummer gets to determine how fast or how slow our heart is beating. We're gonna go with you. You're the drummer. Drummer. All right. So as I name some of the people or the groups of people that we're gonna honor, as I will say Ashe, and then I say Ashe, shout a name out based on who I'm asking you. I want to make sure everybody can see. Can everybody see it? We good? Mm-hmm. All right. So, and just for a little bit of time. All right. So we first want to give our thanks to whoever is overseeing us. Whatever spirit is there, we want to honor. Ashe.
Ashe.
We next want to honor our ancestors. Our ancestors are the ones who toil. They were the trailblazers. They made a way so we could be here, and we stand on their shoulders. So when I say Ashe, just shout out an ancestor or someone that you know that could be an ancestor of yours, all right? Okay, Ashe. Working. Ashe. Say someone else. Ashe. All right, excellent. Now we're also going to honor our elders. As we stand on the shoulders of our ancestors, our elders have our backs. And our elders watch it to make sure that if we fall back, they're going to catch us, they are our safety net, to then, again, lightly continue to push us forward. So I'm going to now ask you to shout out an elder when I say Ashe. 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 Shout them out. Okay. It's important that their spirits be in the room. So in order for that to happen, they gotta hear you. Right? Shout. When I say shout, I mean shout. Outside voice. Okay. All right. So now we also want to honor, those who are present. You all are present. So I would like you to shout your name, okay? And you can shout it, if you want to shout it three times, because I'm going to three times, go right ahead. And I really want to hear you so that we know you are here, you are present. All righty. Those who are present, Ashe. 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 Yes, Ashe. Okay, y'all in the room now. Okay, so now we got these positive spirits that are going, right? All this good stuff. Now, we also know that there are people we don't know who we care about. And so for the visitors or the people who are out there who who we don't know, we want to invite them in. And so think about someone who's not here who you would have liked to be here, because they'll be here in spirit if you say their name. So I'm going to say it three times, right? And Ashe. 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 We also want to honor those who are invisible, those who feel that they don't matter, those who are infirm, or those who are incarcerated, or those who just can't seem to get up in the morning anymore because they just feel alone. We want to shout their names because we want to let them know we are here. We are here to support them. So I'm going to say it three times. Take a moment. And these are the people who are considered, who consider themselves, sometimes we consider them too, invisible. Ashe.
Mary Williams.
Ashe.
Amen.
Ashe. So I honestly want to say to this group, I feel very welcome. I feel the vibes in this room. Positive things that are happening today. Out there in Zoom land, we hear you, we got you. Hello, hello. And I want to thank so much for our people who helped us today, and our hearts kept beating, right? Hello. Ashay, thank you. Let's put those right here. Thank you so much. What's your name? There's Ann.
Delicia.
Ollie.
And Ollie?
Ollie.
And Ollie. Thank you, Ann, Delicia, and Ollie. So we're now going to have a YouTube, and it is a very short one, but it's very powerful. One good thing about short things, you gotta say it, you gotta say it quick, people will hear it and remember. I think you will appreciate this YouTube, and we'll talk a little bit about it after we see.
It's the pen that President Biden used to sign Juneteenth into law. I'm Opal Lee, and I've had this marvelous day at the White House. The young people would say, it's off the chain. I knew I was coming because Juneteenth had been made a national holiday, and the president was signing the bill into law, and I was invited to the signing of that bill.
Looking out across this room, I see the advocates, the activists, the leaders who have been calling for this day for so long, including the one and only Miss Opal Lee.
Over the course of decades, she's made it her mission to see that this day came. She's walked for miles and miles, literally and figuratively, to bring attention to Juneteenth, to make this day possible.
You cannot imagine how joyful, how humble, how magnificent the whole thing has been. There may be some of you who don't know what Juneteenth is. The enslaved in Texas weren't told they were free for 2.5 years after the Emancipation Proclamation freed them. They'd watch in their churches and they'd pray for freedom to come. And it finally did when General Gordon Granger and 7,000 colored troops from New Jersey and New York made their way to Galveston, Texas. And he read General Order Number 3 that said, all slaves are free. When those people came in from their labor and somebody read that to them, we started celebrating, and we've been celebrating ever since. Juneteenth is not a Texas thing. It's not a black thing. We're talking about freedom for everyone.
What it means to be free. Openly in, I think it was 2019, she walked from Fort Worth, Texas to Washington, D.C. Who does that also sound like? Somebody who did a whole lot of walking for freedom. Harriet Tubman. A whole lot of us. A whole lot of our elders and our ancestors have made this so important for us. Her story is the story of Juneteenth in many, many ways because she represents a situation. She is a descendant. We have descendants. What is so important is the fact that we were enslaved. The Emancipation Proclamation came about, which was supposed to free the slaves, what, in the Confederate Army. Why? So that the Africans and the African Americans and the Blacks could join the Union Army. So there were states, there were territories that were not free. Texas was supposed to be free. Texas is known for being a renegade territory. Right? So it was not just that it took a long time, because in order to liberate these states and territories, the federal troops had to come there. Because otherwise, the Southern states, they're like, what, who, what, who? Not us, we don't have to, we the ones that wanted to leave. We're not gonna do that just to now have to, on our own, just volunteer to let our slaves go. So there are a few people who are gonna read some information that gives you a little bit more history about Juneteenth. And we wanna start with, gentlemen, what's your name?
Roger Starr.
Roger, what are you going to read for us?
I'm going to read the general order number 3.
Okay. Before we do that, let's give him some. Yeah. Here's what I need you to do. Oh, wait a minute. I'm not talking to Tasha. You guys see the video about the little girl that lost her shoe when she was running and ended up winning the race and she went back to her dog? Hello. Anyway, okay. So, everybody at your seats. I want you to just stop. Now, I am enslaved in Texas. 2 years it took, but here comes 7,000, many of them African American troops. With Mr. Grant, General Granger here to read a proclamation. So just think about the power that you're already feeling in this room with just how you're marching. Think, just magnify that. What it must have felt like for the enslaved in Texas to start to hear those words.
This is General Order Number 3, which was issued June 19th. 1865, and it goes as follows. The order issued in Galveston on June 19, 1865, by U.S. Major General Gordon Granger, informed the people of Texas that all enslaved people were now free. The people of Texas are informed, in accordance with a proclamation from the executive of the United States, all slaves are free. This involves an absolute equality of personal rights and rights of property between former masters and slaves, and the connection heretofore existing between them becomes now that between employer and hired labor. The freedmen are advised to remain quiet at their present homes and work for wages. They are informed that they will not be allowed to collect at military posts, that they will not be supported in idleness, either there or elsewhere. That's what.
No, it's important. That's why I wanted you to read the actual order. It's important because I'm going to comment.
Yeah. Well, that's it. That's the end of it.
All right. So stay right there because we're going to ask you two things.
Yeah.
Okay. What does the first part talk about? What does it say? Read again.
Okay. The people in Texas are informed that according to the proclamation of the executive of the United States, all slaves are free.
All enslaved are free. Read again, the rest.
This involves an absolute equality of personal rights and rights of property between former masters and slaves. And the connection heretofore existing between them becomes that between employer and hired labor.
Stop right there. It sounds to me like we are free. And that there is a relationship between employer, employee, labor. Actually, sounds more like sharecropping to me. Read some more.
Freedmen are advised to remain quietly in their present homes and work for wages. They are informed that they will not be allowed to collect at military posts and that they will not be supported in idleness, either there or elsewhere.
All right, so even though it says we are absolutely free, are we really? No, there are restrictions. Understand and recognize. They did not want us to be equal in all respects. You can look at the Constitution and see that for yourselves. So what happens so many times, we take what we get and we celebrate the heck out of it, knowing that as we gather our strength between our ancestors and our elders and push forward, we then are able to help to make the true American dream come true for everyone, and it's a struggle even today. So even then, paper said one thing, reality said something different. So it is very important when we are talking about whenever things are given about history, the whole history is our truth. The entire history is our truth. Thank you so much. We have some more readings about Juneteenth that we'd like to share with you at this time.
Margaret and Donna, come on up.
Come on up.
No, I'm good. Thank you. Good evening, everyone.
Good evening. Good evening.
I will share with you the historical legacy of Juneteenth. Emancipation Day celebration, June 19, 1900, held in East Woods on East 24th Street in Austin Credit, Austin History Center. On Freedom's Eve, or the eve of January 1st, 1863, the first watch night services took place. On that night, enslaved and free African Americans gathered in churches and private homes all across the country, awaiting news that the Emancipation Proclamation had taken effect. At the stroke of midnight, prayers were answered as all enslaved people in Confederate states were declared legally free. Union soldiers, many of whom were Black, marched onto plantations and across cities in the South, reading small copies of the Emancipation Proclamation, spreading the news of freedom in Confederate states. Only through the 13th Amendment did emancipation end slavery throughout the United States. But not everyone in Confederate territory would immediately be free. Even though the Emancipation Proclamation was made effective in 1863, it could not be implemented in places still under Confederate control. As a result, in the westernmost Confederate state of Texas, enslaved people would not be free until much later. Freedom finally came on June 19, 1865, when some 2,000 Union troops arrived in Galveston Bay, Texas. The Army announced that more than 250,000 enslaved Black people in the state were free by executive decree. This day became known as Juneteenth by the newly freed people of Texas.
Next. Your name?
Donna.
Thank you.
Post-emancipation period, known as Reconstruction, 1865 to 1877, marked an era of great hope, uncertainty, and struggle for the nation as a whole. Formerly enslaved people immediately sought to reunify families, establish schools, run for political office, push radical legislation, and even sue slaveholders for compensation. Given the 200 years of enslavement, such changes were nothing short of amazing. Not even a generation out of slavery, African Americans were inspired and empowered to transform their lives and their country. Juneteenth marks our country's second Independence Day. Although it has long been celebrated in African American communities, this monumental event remains largely unknown to most Americans. The historical legacy of Juneteenth shows the value of never giving up hope in uncertain times. The National Museum of African American History and Culture is a community space where this spirit of hope lives on, a place where historical events like Juneteenth are shared and new stories with equal urgency are told.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, Donna. Thank you, Roger. Thank you, Margaret. Thank you so much, Margaret. So, you know, it's a, you can hear there's a lot of struggle behind getting Juneteenth to become a national holiday. And did you know that there was a Negro national anthem?
Oh, many of you do.
I told the story that I grew up in New York City, in segregated New York City. And we actually, at assembly, we sang the national anthem, and then we sang the Negro national anthem every time we met. And so I think it's fitting for us to sing the Negro national anthem tonight together. And the lyrics are on the screen. Those of you at home on Zoom, join us also. Although we might not hear you, we will feel you. And Kathy Long, I just want to acknowledge that Kathy Long is here and she will be playing along with us on guitar. So. So can you join us? And I think Lucia will be joining. So Lucia, you're going to stay there? Okay. All right, so please stand and sing with us verse one of the Negro Version.
To the place for which I
says, make a joyful noise. Doesn't have to be a perfect pitch. But it should be a joyful noise. Be made a joyful noise. Hello.
Thank you. Thank you.
So right now, we're going to have a reading from Jackie Daye. You're right behind me. Reading Creation.
Yes.
And you're going to tell us a little bit more about it before we start.
No.
No?
All right, we're going right into Creation with Jackie Daye.
Creation by James Weldon Johnson. And God stepped out on space and he looked around and said, I'm lonely. I'll make me a world, and far as the eye of God could see, darkness covered everything. Blacker than 100 midnights down in Cypress Swamp. And God smiled. And the light broke. And the darkness rolled up on one side, and the light stood shining on the other. And God said, that's good. Then God reached out and took the light in his hands, and God rolled the light around in his hands until he made the sun. And he set that sun ablazing in the heavens, and the light that was left from making the sun, God gathered it up in a shining ball. And he flung it against the darkness, spangling the night with the moon and stars. Then down between the darkness and the light, he hurled the world. And God said, that's good. Then God himself stepped down, and the sun was on his right hand. And the moon was on his left. The stars were clustered about his head, and the earth was under his feet. And God walked, and when he trod, his footsteps hollowed the valleys out and bulged the mountains up. Then he stopped and looked and saw that the earth was hot and barren. So God stepped over to the edge of the world, and he spat out the seven seas. He batted his eyes, and the lightning flashed. He clapped his hands, and the thunders rolled. And the waters above the earth came down. The cooling waters came down. Then the grass sprouted, and the little red flowers blossomed. The pine tree pointed his finger to the sky, and the oak spread out his arms. The lakes cuddled down in the hollows of the ground, and the rivers ran down to the sea. And God smiled again. And the rainbow appeared and curled itself around his shoulder. Then God raised his arm and he waved his hand over the sea and over the land, and he said, bring forth, bring forth. And quicker than God could drop his hand, fishes and fowls and beasts and birds swam the rivers and the seas, roamed the forests and the woods, and split the air with their wings. And God said, that's good. Then God walked around, and God looked around. On all that he had made, he looked at his sun, and he looked at his moon, and he looked at his little stars. He looked on his world with all its living things. And God said, I'm lonely still. Then God sat down on the side of a hill where he could think. By a deep, wide river, he sat down. with his head in his hands. God thought and thought till he thought, I'll make me a man. Up from the bed of the river, God scooped the clay. And by the bank of the river, he kneeled him down. And there, the great God Almighty, who lit the sun and fixed it in the sky, who flung the stars to the most far corner of the night, who rounded the earth in the middle of his hand, this great God, like a mammy bending over her baby, kneeled down in the dust, toiling over a lump of clay. Then he shaped it in his own image. Then into it, he blew the breath of life. And man became a living soul. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you. The creation. Mm-hmm. Woo. Mm-hmm. I'm pleased, I'm blessed as we are. So now we're going to have a little fun. We want to hear a little more from you about how you're thinking, what you're thinking about. So the way we're going to have this, we have some words in this basket. And we're going to have someone pick the word. And then I'll read the word. No, you can read the word. Pick the word, read the word. And then we just want to shout out, what does it say to you? So I'm not even gonna give you an example because it's all gonna kind of flow. All right, so who wants to first pick a word? There are no wrong answers, because it's how you feel about it.
And Cheryl, people on Zoom can write it in chat.
Absolutely, write in chat so we can all hear and see you.
Jim, can we see it?
13th Amendment.
13th Amendment, what does that say?
Freedom.
Freedom.
Struggle.
Truth. All right, so we'll do the three, because three seem to be going our way today. Okay. All right. His word is openly. Okay. And then we have a green is for the people and the land. It's for the land. And well, black is for the people, and then our green is for the. All right, let's try on this side. June 2021. We saw. Hello. That's right. What does that say? What has that done? What did it launch? A national federal holiday. How many federal holidays do people of color get to celebrate?
Two.
All right. And you know what? That means everyone, because when we celebrate, everybody celebrates. Hello. Absolutely. But for us, particularly in terms of the focus being on our race and the strides that we've made, we have Juneteenth, which is about our freedom, and we have Martin Luther King's birthday, which is love for everybody. But of course, he wasn't always loved by everybody, was he?
No.
No, we will. All right, who else? Why don't you try?
Emancipation Proclamation.
The Emancipation Proclamation. Talk about it. What was it? What is it? We talked about it already. The Confederate States. The enslaved in Confederate States were free. Was everybody else free by the proclamation? No. And you notice DC has its own Liberation Day. I'm going to reach back here a little bit. You want to try?
Families.
Families. Yes, exactly. United family.
Yes.
Celebration, right?
Comfort.
Reunion, right?
Elders,
absolutely. Families. And remember, the enslaved oftentimes ended up with broken families because they could not guarantee that the family of which they born were the family of which they would live the entire time. So think about how important family is when you know that your ancestors didn't necessarily have families that were blood. But you know what? Those who worked with them, became their extended family.
That's right.
And that's what we're known for. Okay, we're gonna do two more. Who wants to be?
Emancipation.
Okay, pick another. We want to make sure we say that two or three times.
U.S. colored troops of 700.
Okay, actually
7,000.
There we go. What do we know about them?
They came into Galveston.
Yes.
They
were the ones marching, right? That's it. They were the ones that were marching. Okay, I'm going to tell you what. There's one, I'm going to pretend like I picked it. And it is red, white, and blue. Now, it's a little bit tricky.
France.
It's a little bit tricky. Okay, what do we know? What do we know is red, white, and blue? The American flag, right? Okay.
Galveston.
Now, you see, this is also red, white, and blue.
What is it?
This is actually, although it's actually turned this way, flag. This is the first Juneteenth flag.
Oh, wow.
Was red and the star, lone star of what territory? Texas. So you have a star, then you have like a star burst, which is in essence about our freedom. And then there's a horizon. If you look at it this way, yes, there's a horizon. The red is a horizon, hope for the future. Beautiful. And then later, the June 19th, 1865, was placed on that flag. So the very first Juneteenth celebrations, because they also wanted to recognize and understand that the star and the starburst was freedom for everybody. Freedom for everybody. And that horizon reminds us about the hope for the future.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, Cheryl.
Thank
you so much for bringing something participatory to us.
Yeah.
It's great to improvise, and it's great to just share what we're thinking, what's on the top of our minds, the top of our hearts. Well, right now, I just wanted to take a moment and just think about all of the simple gifts that we have in life. Some of the words that came up, family, freedom. It's important to take a moment and just acknowledge and be grateful for so much that we have, including our struggles, also our triumphs. So we're going to sing Simple Gifts, and I'd like everyone to join if you can. The lyrics are on the screen. Joan is going to join us as well. Are you going to play?
Yeah.
Yes, Kathy is going to play. We're going to just come on up to the yes, here's a mix. So join us. It seems like it was 2021, so it seems like it was 2 years ago. Yeah, almost a year and a half.
The hill we climb. Mr. President, Madam Vice President, Americans, and the world. When day comes, we ask ourselves, where can we find light in this never-ending shade? The loss we carry, a sea we must wade. We've braved the belly of the beast. We've learned that quiet isn't always peace, and the norms and notions of what just is isn't always just is. And yet the dawn is ours before we knew it. Somehow we do it. Somehow we've weathered and witnessed a nation that isn't broken, but simply unfinished. We, the successors of a country and a time where a skinny black girl descended from slaves and raised by a single mother, can dream of becoming president only to find herself reciting for one. And yes, we are far from polished, far from pristine, but this doesn't mean we are striving to form a union that is perfect. We are striving to forge our union with purpose, to compose a country committed to all cultures, colors, and characters of man. And so we lift our gazes not to what stands between us, but what stands before us. We close the divide because we know to put our future first, we must first put our differences aside. We lay down our arms so we can reach our arms to one another. We seek harm to none and harmony for all. Let the globe, if nothing else, say this is true. That even as we grieved, we grew. That even as we hurt, we hoped. That even as we tired, we tried. That we'll forever be tied together, victorious. Not because we will never again know defeat, but because we will never again sow division. Scripture tells us to envision that everyone shall sit under their own vine and fig tree, and no one shall make them afraid. If we're to live up to our own time, then victory won't lie in the blade, but in all the bridges we've made. That is the promised glade, the hill we climb, if only we dare it, because being American is more than a pride we inherit. It's the past we step into and how we repair it. We've seen a force that would shatter our nation rather than share it, would destroy our country if it meant delaying democracy. And this effort very nearly succeeded. But while democracy can be periodically delayed, it can never be permanently defeated. In this truth, in this faith, we trust. For while we have our eyes on the future, history has its eyes on us. This is the era of just redemption. We feared it at its inception. We did not feel prepared to be the heirs of such a terrifying hour. But within it, we found the power to author a new chapter, to offer hope and laughter to ourselves. So while once we asked, how could we possibly prevail over catastrophe? Now we assert, how could catastrophe possibly prevail over us? We will not march back to what was, but move to what shall be, a country that is bruised, but whole, benevolent, but bold, fierce, and free. We will not be turned around or interrupted by intimidation, because we know our inaction and inertia will be the inheritance of the next generation. Our blunders become their burdens, but one thing is certain. If we merge mercy with might and might with right, then love becomes our legacy and change our children's birthright. So let us leave behind a country better than the one we were left. With every breath from our bronze pounded chests, we will raise this wounded world into a wondrous one. We will rise from the gold-limbed hills of the West. We will rise from the windswept Northeast where our forefathers first realized revolution. We will rise from the lake-rimmed cities of the Midwestern states. We will rise from the sun-baked South. We will rebuild, reconcile, and recover in every known nook of our nation, in every corner called our country. Our people, diverse and dutiful, will emerge battered but beautiful. When day comes, we step out of the shade, aflame and unafraid. The new dawn blooms as we free it, for there is always light if only we're brave enough to see it, if only we're brave enough to be it.
And let love be our legacy.
So we are. Well, you know, we gotta stop the commercial sometimes. So we're going to head into the closing of the ceremony. Thank you so much for coming. Thank you so much for showing up for the second year, and we're going to continue. Yeah. Juneteenth is a national holiday. So glad to see you on Zoom. And we are going to have Betty come in and lead us in breath and prayers, and then we're going to do a community sing, This Little Light of Mine. And I just want to thank you again for showing up in person and on Zoom. Yes, let love be our legacy. We're continuing to climb that hill.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
Betty.
Roxanne. Thanks, Roxanne, and everybody for all this wonderful program tonight. Yes, our second annual, the beginning of a trend. So we stand in this place, in this space, and we honor this place we're at tonight. And we started tonight honoring this land that was stolen from the indigenous people, the Piscataway who lived here. So we're going to close with this ceremony that the natives would prepare, but the natives would do that too. So I'm going to ask you to join me. Those of you at home, I would invite you also to stand and figure out which is east. To us, east is this way. So I'm going to ask you to stand up and face the direction of east. And I'm going to invite you to raise your hands to the sky and take a deep breath in and bring your hands into prayer pose and bring them down to your heart. You might make a little bow. We're bowing to the direction of the east. This is the direction of water, the direction of clear minds, of meditation, to the direction of the east. Now step to your right, to the south. And again, raise your hands, take a deep breath in. Put your hands in a prayer pose. Take a little bow if you like, and honor the direction of the south. This is the direction of fire, the direction of heart, openness, our connectedness. Oh. And then take a direct step to your right. For the west, the sun is setting. Again, raise your hands, take a deep breath in. Bring your hands down to prayer pose as you exhale. A little bow forward in the direction of the west, the direction of earth, mindfulness, meditation, going within, honoring our bodies. Oh, then to the direction of north, again, raising your hands, calling in the energies of the universe, bringing them into our heart space with our hands in the prayer pose. This is the direction of spirit, the direction of air, of our ancestors and the winged ones and the white-haired ones. Again, we honor the direction of the north. And then let's come face each other, kind of face the circle. And then the Mayans then add the direction of the sky, which is part of the sky, and bow to the heart of the earth. Coming into our heart, knowing that our hearts are all connected. And the native, the indigenous people said, ho. I invite you to say, ho. Looks like you have some soul in mind. So, those of you on screen, please join us. Of course, you need to mute it, but sing to yourself, sing really loud. This is a little light of mine.
And everyone should have a little light. And this is your anchor to take with you to remember this glorious day and this great celebration. Anyone?
Oh, Charlotte, thank you. All right, ready? Kathy on guitar. Thank you so much again, Kathy.
I'm gonna make it.
those of us who are still here, please join Sophie with the collaborative painting and join us for snacks and drinks and a little fellowship. Take care, everyone at home. Good night. See you soon.
Good night.
Good night.
Good night.
Oh,